Arthur, great to bump into you as always. I want to learn more about these Louis Belay tools. What's on offer?
We've got five ranges on the stand here, and they are all very, very material specific. The days of buying an end mill that'll do lots of materials is gone. You know, people want tool life, people want surface finish. You can only achieve that by having the right geometry for the right material and also the right coating. So within the Belay range, we've got stainless steel and titanium as our aerospace direction. We've got aluminium and brass, and we've also got composite materials, which is relatively new to Belay and has got some interesting capabilities.
Okay, but it's not just straightforward end mills. There's some quite small, intricate tools here.
Well, if I start on the composite tools, an important feature is that we start at 0.48 of a mil diameter, whereas a lot of other composite end mill and drill suppliers are starting much bigger. So we've got a niche market that we're trying to get over to our customers about on size. That gives us a huge range of tools before our competition even get involved.
In terms of composite market, people obviously think of aerospace and things like that, but it's a lot more than that now, isn't it? It's in parts that go in the human body, it's even watchmaking now, composites.
Oh, without doubt. And then if you refer to the watchmaking, Rafa Nadal's got a watch made of composite parts made with Louis Belay tools. And that's quite open on the internet on that. But you can only achieve that if you've got the sizes available to do it.
And obviously here we've got a slitting saw. Is that material specific as well?
Yes. On our slitting saws, we start at 0.1 of a mil width, and we can have different numbers of teeth on the periphery and different IDs and ODs. So you've got a good range there to solve each individual customer's problems.
Yeah, it's good. Like you say, there's universal tools. There's a lot of universal tools out there. But the issue with those, there's always a compromise. You might leave a burr on a component, or you might sacrifice tool life or productivity. But with Louis Belay, you're hammering down the details, aren't you?
You've got to hammer the detail, because in micro machining, you can't afford to have a burr. So the tools have got to be sharp and make a clean cut. And that also then impacts on surface finish.
And at Rainford Precision, you know a little bit about micro precision, don't you? Micro machining?
Just a little bit, yeah. It's our key competence. We have sold drills as small as 8 micron diameter, and we start our drilling range at 0.1, going up in 10 micron increments. And the micro area is quite exciting and really, really interesting to be involved in.
Yeah, it's a growing sector. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Joe.